YouTube, I messed up. I reacted to this, but my mic was so quiet. So we're gonna try again. This is one of my most elite students. Watermelon, watermelon. Our audio seems good enough. I want to record this because it says last. All right. The roller MNK divide is only getting worse. People are consistently coming in and MNK players that are really, really good and then saying, fuck it, I'm going roller. Fuck it, I'm leaving. I'm leaving the game entirely. And so I won't be surprised if this is actually the last video. But I wanted to go a little bit into what stands out to me, especially having coached this player multiple times and seeing that I helped him a lot. So let's just get into it. Now, I want you guys to notice something simple. He's not reacting to his own movement. He's moving the enemy's hitbox and he's turning their hitbox and he's turning their strafe pattern. So everyone comes at you and they're strafing like boom, 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 whatever they're doing. When you turn to their side, this pattern, you know, the angle shifts and it goes more towards this pattern and then in between, diagonal. Versus it becomes way slower, way more, I don't know, just easy to shoot. You look at them at an angle and you also force them to turn. So see how this guy has now just been forced to go from turning like this to turning like this. This is curving his strafe. It is fucking curving his strafe like crazy for just a little bit. But you can repeatedly do it and you can lock them in place. So you're looking at them from an angle and you're spinning them around. So how straight are their strafes really? They're just not really. Not hard to hit. I want you guys to notice that movement speed shifts as he spins the target. It's in his bones. I want you to feel the difference and I want you to feel how it's like not in your bones. Notice when you turn people, you get surprised that, oh, they're so slow. I'm turning them, but I'm over-aiming or I'm under-aiming. I'm just not feeling them slow down. But it's guaranteed. Every single time, the enemy just feels slow from his POV. Remember how that feels? Why are you AD spamming? Are you recoil smoothing from 10 feet away with a 1 to 2? On a dude with his back to you? Come on, bro. All right. Good example of some cringe. Feel your keyboard shaking the fucking target around. This will help you understand influence on movement speed and stuff and like the movement speed slows that are beneficial to a target trying to surprise you, but you know, there's also harm to it. Look at it from both angles if you really want to benefit from it. But look at this, Math. What the fuck you doing, bro? This guy's got his back to you. You trying to recoil smooth the fucking 1-2 from a guy with his back turned to you, or am I tripping? You see that? Where is he facing? Come on! Anyways, let that sink in. Notice how the enemy has a very specific velocity based on their angle. Everybody knows that the speed changes. This is nothing new. But do you feel it? And how vivid is that feeling? How much do you miss because your vividness is blurry or some shit, you know? It's important. It's not just about techniques and stuff. It is, but also don't miss out on how it feels. Otherwise, you miss out on the advantage. Slow, like sluggish, man. Look at that guy. Empathize with him. He's trying to AD spam. He's not just a mannequin sitting on a fucking flagpole. He's genuinely trying to trade here. Look at this. Strafes to the left. Strafes to the right. Strafes to the left. Strafes to the right. Strafes further to the right. You know, he's trying to mix it up too. But he's just being turned on his fucking, on his feet, on his ankles. So already he's moving so slow. I want you to focus on these two things of feedback. Where his eyes are facing, where his bullet trail is, at the very least. And feel the angle. This is like a 45 degree angle. Imagine this, from 90 degrees, there's no movement from 90 degrees. From 45 degrees, it's a 50% slow and it's gradual in between. So you want to be able to not lose track. Gain some satisfaction from shooting people whilst being able to see their ears. Gain some dissatisfaction when you're unable to see their ears and unable to feel them slow down from that. This will change you. Look at that. These people all feel like flagpoles just getting turned. The forbidden tech. Using your brain. You can also look at situations like this differently. When you've got people like this, you can feel them seeing your side and you can be protecting your side, you know, protecting your ears from being spotted. And you can feel like their advantage of that. Whether or not they're aware, if they're slowing your movement speed, you can protect that a little bit and may as well slow their movement speed too. Even though both of your movement speeds kind of stationary, if you give them your side, you're going to be slow anyways and they might be faster. And it's very perceptual, network lag, reaction time based. It's just get more empathetic. How many times per trade there's like moments where the enemy is looking sideways, and count how many times you feel the slow of that. Find a disconnect and you're gonna start to stick to the enemy kind of like this. Notice how if you can feel yourself consistently turning the enemy, you can feel a buildup of their reaction speed, like they are playing catch up, and it starts to feel like you are catching the enemy in like a baseball mitt. Once you find a little little opening for them to have to make up for, you can, as you feel them, as you feel their recovery, you can like sabotage it. You gotta be able to feel it. It's this timing of when he stretches them super to the side and then swaps. You feel like a whip sensation from the enemy's neck. And from that whipping sensation in their neck, swinging back and forth, remember, their strafe is getting whiplash, and their strafes are no longer straight, and their two-dimensional velocity is like super, 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 super duper different. It's gonna be slow. And you're gonna miss if you don't feel that. You just will.
Okay, just fucking did some fucking M&K shit. Feedback, M&K loser, and all he can do is tap strafe.
Literally.
Sing and sing.
All we can do is tap strafe.
Yeah. You didn't kill him?
Yeah. Bro, I hit him like 60. I watched the POV of you getting like freaking Neo saved on, bro. That was insane.
He doing it again. The 100 pumps him. Bro,
put it on the
bed.
Feel, okay, so remember, this is what it looks like from their POV. And remember what Map's POV looks like. He sees much, much more of their side than it really feels like they are exposing. Remember that. Because you'll realize people are doing this to you unintentionally or intentionally. You got to be able to look through their reaction speed, your reaction speed, and network lag.
He's doing it again.
And perceptual movement slows. All that time spent tracking left to right and then having to start like bouncing when he starts jiggling. Feel the, try to draw a line in your mind of this guy's strafe. Feel how curved it is. Feel the change in the straightness and the curvature and the angle.
Mierda!
Do you feel that? It's curving like a banana a little bit. Alright, hopefully we see more. Hopefully this isn't the last one. God damn it, don't let it be the last. Don't let it be the last. I'm gonna leave a link, leave a comment, tell them that it shan't be the last. Have a good night. Peace out. Hopefully this helped you and your journey to become a mechanical beast. Remember, this is not up to your peripheral or anything, your input, anything like that. It doesn't matter if you're roller MNK. The stuff that I was trying to point out is just universal, right? Have fun. Peace out. Let me know.